Hi friends, this is Katie again, and this time let's walk through the Create Screencastomatic option for recording inside of Canvas Studio. So this is another option, and this one is actually launching a Screencastomatic tool. Now, if you haven't done this yet, you're gonna be prompted to download something first. And in fact, let's see if it prompts me to do that because I've already Yes, so if you haven't loaded it before, you're going to be prompted to download and install on a new computer that you haven't recorded on before. In my case, I've already done that. It's just that I didn't click the Open Screen Recorder Launcher in time. So I'm going to go ahead and open the Screen Recorder Launcher, and it should give me the option, the black and white. Yeah. Okay. So what I'm looking for, once I know Screencastomatic has successfully launched, I get that black and white frame around the recording area. So that's what I'm looking for. That's what signals to me that I know Screencastomatic is running. Basically what I'm gonna do is position the frame around whatever it is I wanna record. And I can pick it up by using this little crosshair in the middle of the screen of the frame and clicking on that and moving it around to wherever I need my recording to be. I'm gonna click over to my presentation slides because that's what I'm going to be recording again as part of this demo. You guys have heard these slides before, seen these slides before. Notice that you can click and drag the bars along the edge of your recording frame so that it fits your content as it needs to. You can also make that recording frame larger if you need to. So, you know, size that as you need, as you see fit. The other thing is that right now you're seeing my webcam. So I'm recording both the webcam as well as the screen capture, just like we did in the studio capture option. That's because both is selected right here. Maybe I just want to do a talking head video and I can do just a talking head video, then I would just select webcam. If I just want to record the screen, then I would just record screen and you're not going to see the webcam in the recording. I'm going to keep both just so you can see and compare kind of how this compares to the studio capture option. Notice that it is capturing my narration, so it's got a microphone that it has found that it is detecting audio from. So before we saw the blue bar, and now you're seeing a little green bar in this option. Computer audio is whether or not I want it to record the system audio. Like if there's anything in my presentation that has audio, do I want it to record it? And yes, in this case, it's set to record. You can change that whatever you prefer. Okay, once I'm ready to record, I'm gonna hit the recording button. It's gonna count me down. I'm gonna do a silly little sample presentation like I did before, and then you'll see the process for me to stop the recording. Okay, so let's do that. I'm gonna hit record. It's gonna count me down. And now I'm giving my presentation. Thanks everybody for being here. Thank you for listening. Today I'm gonna talk to you about my sample presentation. And if you don't know already, my name is Demo Student. I'm gonna take you through this list as part of my sample presentation. I hope you enjoy it, blah, blah, blah. And that brings us to topic two. It's really important that you know about list item one, list item two, and list item three. Hey, thanks for listening to my presentation. I really appreciate that. I hope you found this useful. Have a great day. All right, when I'm done recording, I'm gonna hit the pause button. And that lets me see, okay, right now I'm at 38 seconds. If I wanted to, in fact, if I wasn't done recording, I could pause and then hit record again, and it's gonna allow me to continue recording where I left off. So that's really handy if you wanna do like a slide at a time and you just wanna record a slide, pause. Gather your thoughts, think about what you wanna say, then record the slide and pause. So that would be one way of doing it, another way of doing it. So in this case though, it looks like also I have an option to draw on my slides. I'm keeping it simple, so I'm not gonna do that. Feel free to experiment with that, but don't hit the delete and start over unless that's your plan, unless that's what you wanna do. You can hit the done button once you're done recording, and that's what I'm gonna go ahead and do. So here you can see that it grabbed a bunch of my audio. That's a good sign. The first thing I do is make sure that I see the audio waves below the video. That means it was successfully recording my audio. You can also preview it so you can hit play.
And now I'm giving my presentation. Thanks everybody for being here. Thank you for...
You can see where that it captured my webcam. So that was part of my presentation as well, part of the recording. And here I'm going to give it a title, Katie Sample. This is going to be Screencast-O-Matic Recording. So give it a title, and here's where we're going to be uploading it. Now, if you wanted to do editing on your project, this is where you'll have more editing capabilities than you have with the other Studio Capture option. So I'll just show you real quick. If I wanted more editing in here, you'll see that instead of just, let's see, we had trim. Now we had cut. I don't see trim here, but it's probably just inside of cut. You can see that there's all sorts of different options. You can overlay, highlight, arrow shapes. You can change the speed. You can create transitions. So you have a few more options when you're editing in Screencast-O-Matic than when you're editing in the screen capture in straight studio. So I'm gonna not make any of these changes, but look, it would let me like move this around if I wanted to, or like if I wanna make that bigger or whatever. I mean, I could make some of those changes. I'm gonna cancel and I'm gonna say done for editing. But just so you know that there are more editing options in Screencast-O-Matic, I just don't want to get into it because that's a whole much longer, different video topic. Okay, so I'm going to hit upload because I've given it an option, and it's uploading it to Canvas Studio. So the goal here is for us to see a new video in my library in Canvas Studio. So let's see if that's the case. I'm going to go to my Canvas Studio tab, and sure enough, it looks like this is the 39-second video that I just recorded. So that's it. Obviously, we have more to do because we have to caption it and we can edit it. Notice you will be able to edit the videos that you record in Screencast-O-Matic. You will be able to edit them in the Canvas Studio editor as well. So you can still do cutting and trimming with these videos. But you'll also be able to, of course, do, like I said, more editing in the Screencast-O-Matic tool before you get it uploaded. Once it's been uploaded, you can't now say, oh, I want to go do the editing in Screencast-O-Matic. There's no way, at least none that I know of, where you can go get that, get those editing tools opened again. It's already been uploaded to the server. Okay, and then you'd follow the same instructions, the same steps for captioning, for which are processing right now, but you'll be able to review and publish captions once those are processed, and you're good to go. So that's recording using the Create Screencast-O-Matic option in Canvas Studio. Thanks for watching.